I've always wanted to go there. Any pictures I've seen of the place are sick. After a few emails back and forth, before I knew it, things were getting organised and that was it, we were going. Chart for where we were going, and it wasn't looking up to much at all really, but at the same time we didn't really know what we were looking for, and there was so much organisation went into the trip that we thought, let's just go up there and have a look around and see what we can find and just sort of check the place out really. After hours and hours of British motorway, we eventually arrived at the ferry port.
It sounds like killing off your ass.
Walking is all the way.
I hate to see a tail get dinged.
The place where we got the ferry from was just incredible. Like, it looked like a movie set or something. It was just so many massive mountains around and just so different to home. The ferry ride over was incredible too. It was mental. When we got there, none of us obviously knew where we were going, and we were working with little information, so we figured if we check the spot, which is pretty much facing directly into the swell, we can get an idea of how big it is and where to go from there really.
It looks like there could be a little left bank down there. Definitely a right in this corner.
It was kind of small and looked sort of unrideable, so we decided to just sort of jump in the car with the tom-tom and see if we could find any little setups.
That beach is like...
Tom Tom didn't work the whole time we were there, so that was put in the glove box.
If I'm honest, from this angle, it doesn't look like there's much in between.
So we ended up on this little track going up this hill on the top of a mound, and there was a graveyard on the top there, and it looked about 3 foot or so. I don't know whether it was sand or reef, I'm not really sure even now, but once we seen it was rideable, we kind of all just got changed. The boys were kind of frothing out and getting a bit overexcited. Noah was struggling a bit, he couldn't even put his boots on. I think it was the first time he's ever put boots on.
Never worn boots, like, do you wear them on the outside?
The room every time you leave. Fall apart because you're all I need. You make me late for work. You make me late for church. So hard to leave. So bring on, bring on the weekend. Bring it on, bring on the weekend.
So hot, hot, hot.
So bring it on.
After the surf, we packed everything up and got back to the house to meet Reubyn and the boys who were on the later ferry. We were starving from surfing and obviously they were starving from travelling, so we went and got a load of food and cooked up a big, massive meal.
Big.
Next day we woke up not super early, just kind of cruising.
Didn't bring my hard
ones,
yeah, but they're actually they're fine. You say they're fully waterproof.
So. Oh,
their
ankles are.
I think it was Ben who had a friend who gave him some info on a spot further south. Kind of picked up more swell when there's absolutely nothing. This is the place to go check to see if there'll be something to ride. So we got in the car and started heading down there about 2 hours drive, I think.
I'm actually gonna go wild. Well, I'm gonna go buy an axe.
I know, I can imagine you being one of them people. You just find your phone in a bush one day.
Got there and had a look and there were some waves and we all got in.
It's the time of the season when love runs high. In this time, give it to me easy and let me try with pleasured hands to take you in this time to promise.
The boys had some good waves. I know Noah and Jobe had a couple of real nice ones, but me and Rube's had a bit of a shocker, but you know, you live and learn.
What's your name? Who's your daddy?
Who's your daddy?
He rich. Is he rich like me? Has he taken
any time to show?
To show you what you need to.
After surfing, we wrapped things up down south. We went and got some food and we went and checked the same spot that we'd surfed the day before. Turned out there was another little wave there, so it kind of seemed to be our go-to spot where there always seemed to be something. We got changed and got in there. So try and squeeze a few in just before sunset.
Like me,
has he taken
any time
to show?
Show you what you need to live.
Tell it to me slowly.
Tell you what
I really want to know. It's the time of the season for love.
The chart for the next day was looking good. Like it looked like there's going to be some solid swell and the wind was going to be kind of blowing offshore.
This is going to be 2.4 meters at 18 seconds.
So we got our heads down and made sure we were up nice and early next day.
It's too early for speed.
We got up dead early. Like our plan was to check some of the setups that we'd seen when we were hunting, when we weren't surfing, and everywhere kind of just was looking completely different with swell on it, as it does. Like when it's flat, you kind of think you can see little setups, and turns out that it's in the middle of a channel, or it never quite looks the same. So we ended up going back down to where we surfed the day before. When we got there, it was pretty hairy, it looked solid, and it was real clean, and it was coming through nice. It looked like little A-frame barrels. Everyone was frothing, we all got changed, and we're getting in there like as quick as possible.
By the time we come in, there's gonna be a bar built right there.
Done saying, I'm done playing. Last time is on the outro. Stuck in the house, need to get out more. I've been stacking up like I'm fundraising. Most people in my position get complacent. Wanna come places with star girls and they end up on them front pages. I'm quiet with it, I just ride with it. Moment I stop having fun with it, I be done with it. I'm the only one that's putting shots up, and like a potluck, you need to come with it. Don't run from it. Like H-Town in the summertime, I keep it 100. Met a lot of girls in my times there, and word of Paul Wall, not one fronted. I was birthed there in my first year, man, I know that place like I come from it. Backstage at warehouse and 09, like it's one coming. Fuck that, is anyone coming before I show up there and there's no one there? These days, I could probably pack it for like 20 nights if I go in there. Back rub for my main thing, I've been stressed out. Talking to her like back then, they didn't want me, I'm blessed now.
Don't know what it is about me in this spot, but we didn't click. I didn't have quite as big a shock as Reubyn, though. I'm sure he snapped his board first paddle out, so that's a shocker, especially if it's your favourite board. After we surfed, we were all pretty keen to get on the road and see what we could find to make the most of the swell. And stopped into a petrol station on our travels and ended up bumping into a local legend. We had a cup of tea and was talking about different spots, and he ended up taking us to this right-hander.
Someone go tell Noel to get it backwards. Money got my whole family going backwards. No dinners, no holidays, no nothing. This issue's at hand and we're not discussing. I did not sign up for this. My uncle used to have all these things on his bucket list, and now he's acting like, oh well, this is life, I guess. Nah, fuck that shit. Listen, man, you can still do what you wanna do. You gotta trust that shit. Heard once that in dire times when you need a sign, that's when they appear. Guess since my text message didn't resonate, I'll just say it here. I hate the fact my mom cooped up in the apartment, telling herself that she's too sick to get dressed up and go do shit. Like that's true shit. And all my family from the M town that I've been around start treating me like I'm him now. Like we don't know each other, we ain't grow together, we just friends now. Shit got me feeling pinned down. Pick the pen up or put the pen down. I'm writing to you from a distance like a pen pal, but we been down.
Don't think about it too much, too much, too much, too much. There's no need for us to rush it through. Don't think about it too much, too much, too much, too much.
So that was the boys' final surf. We were heading home the next day, so we got back and packed our things together to prepare our bodies for the enormous trek home.
Now the set is works of art, we're done. No room all wrap, the walls are full. But Lowry didn't care much anyway. They said he just paints cats and dogs and matched up men in boots and clubs. And Lowry said that's just the way they'll stay. And he painted matched up men and matched up cats. Matched up.